Good afternoon, everyone. It's Kirsten here from Kirsten Foss Coaching and also with our sister company, Virtual Spa Business Management, where we have some digital services that we offer for spa owners. So today I want to talk about what do we do to have a busy January? Because it's, you know, if you've been in this industry for a while, you know that there's a natural seasonality to our industry. And, you know, it can be really frustrating, especially if you haven't quite nailed your kind of your business systems and your structure, kind of basically your success system. And if you haven't done that yet, you probably find you're still searching and feeling like you've got that hit and miss situation going on with your growth strategies. So what I wanted to do today is to share my number one strategy to increase your bookings and therefore your service sales and your retail sales in January. So here's the thing, we got to plan this stuff out. If you're waiting until, you know, after the holidays to look at your schedule and then panic about how busy it is or not busy it is for you and your team, it's way too late. We have to start these kinds of initiatives way, way, way earlier than what you're normally used to. So when we work with our clients for our digital marketing services, they're often not surprised, but one of the big things that they have to get used to at the beginning is that we're constantly working at least a month ahead in terms of their social media or their email marketing or their blogging. And so what that means is that we have more time to be able to dig into the details of those promotions, of those ideas about growth, you know, whatever the growth initiative is that you want to share. So that's why I'm talking to you at the beginning of November about what you need to be doing in December to make sure that January has some bookings in it. So you're not sitting there wondering, oh my gosh, how are we going to get more bookings without feeling too desperate, without putting things on sale? I'm just going to check my comments here, kind of find this new Facebook Creator Studio, doing Facebook Lives in here, just a little bit different than what Pages are. So as a little side note, anybody noticing or feeling just as crazy using Facebook, because they're doing a lot of changes in the back end and it's just causing a lot of glitches for things. So you may be finding yourself on your social media, like buttons are missing, options are missing, features are missing. That's okay. We just have to make do and figure it out. Anyways, so what do you want to know? How to make a busy January in December. All right, here's my number one strategy that I share with my coaching clients, especially if they know they've got kind of a soft January bookings, if that's kind of a normal thing. And especially this year with COVID, you know, it's not been a normal year. So, you know, we have to kind of pull out all the stuff in our little, in our tickle trunks, for those of you that used to watch Mr. Dress Up when you were little. We have to kind of pull these kinds of concepts out to make sure that we're not waiting too long before we can make any change. So what is it that I recommend for spas to do in December to ensure a busy January? My suggestion is to give your December clients, those that have booked, a bounce back coupon for a service, a very specific service in January. Now, a bounce back coupon, you may be familiar with that term. They're very commonly used in retail. You'll probably have noticed them if you've shopped at Old Navy or, you know, any of the kids' clothing stores. You often will get a little coupon to come back within a period of time to save, right? So we're going to use that same kind of concept for the spa industry. And how you do that is in November, so that's why we're talking about it now. In November, the first thing you need to do is to actually create your offer. Decide what that offer is. So what is the bounce back going to be? For my clients, I usually recommend that it's for a service that you are trying to build up. So what you're doing is that you're leveraging the clients that come in December for whatever they come in for, their favorite services. Maybe it's a pedicure, maybe it's lashes, maybe it's a facial. But you are trying to drive some booking traffic into a very specific service. So if you have a new facial that, you know, like an advanced skin treatment that you've launched in the fall or maybe earlier in the spring and it's still not kind of grabbing yet, maybe use that particular offer. So it's, for example, the advanced facial. We'll use that. And anybody coming in December would get a coupon for that advanced facial with some sort of either value add or a discount, whatever you feel right by doing. Now, it doesn't have to be a deep discount. It's really just trying to encourage booking. So this could be called a pre-booking promotion, definitely. Other ways of doing pre-booking promotions have been where, all of your December clients, you put them in a draw, they get something for pre-booking their, January, February, March appointments. But this is very, very specific, very, very pointed, very, very focused. January only, that's what it's trying to build. So in November, you're gonna decide on your offer. What's the service gonna be for January for that bounce back? You're going to decide what your coupon design looks like. Keep it simple, peeps. Make something in Canva. There's templates in there that you can use. If you don't like doing any kind of design work in Canva or it's not your jam, hire it out. There's lots of graphic artists getting started that would like to do this kind of thing. If you're actually really on a tight budget, other things, you can just hire it out to your graphic designer if you have somebody that's created your logo for you. So create your offer, decide what it's going to be, decide what the kind of the promotional part of it is, whether it's a discount or whether it's a value add. Maybe you're adding a complimentary LED to it. Maybe you're adding a complimentary eye treatment. Maybe you're adding, there's lots of stuff that you can add on, especially with skin therapy. Then what you want to do in November, the third step is to print out your coupons. You can do this on Vistaprint. You can do it on just a really high quality printer. But whatever you do, have this all ready to go by December 1st. All right. Now, the last step to do in November is to prep your audience, prep your followers on social media. Send out an email in November telling everybody what happens in December when you've booked an appointment. So anybody that's already booked in December will just automatically get this. And then of course it acts as like a pre-booking incentive if you're not completely booked in December. So included in your social media in November and December, included in your email marketing in November and December. And then when it comes to December at checkout, each one of those clients gets one of your bounce back coupons. Now, there's a couple of little caveats about this bounce back coupon that you want to have printed on it. And that is a timeline. So you definitely want to have a small timeline for this. So for those of you that tend to have lots of bookings for January, just keep it as it's valid until January 31st. For those of you that are, kind of looking pretty booked up normally in January, but you're just looking for a little bit extra bookings, but you're not sure how many people can actually get in January, then you could let this lengthen out to be a 60-day expiry rather than 30 days. So it would expire at the end of November. You can be flexible with it just depending on kind of where you're at with your business and what your business goals are for that. All right, that's it. Short and sweet today. A pre-booking promotion. Essentially, it's a bounce back coupon for all December clients to be able to use in January, sometimes in February. Now, this is not a coupon that you give out to clients that have not booked in December. It's meant to reward those that have already pre-booked and that are already coming in, not just to kind of willy-nilly give out kind of coupons or discounts, that kind of thing. All right. So I've had lots of success with this with my coaching clients. I know last year, one of my clients, she was a solo and she did this and she ended up actually using a facial that she was launching. It hadn't actually been really kicked off yet. And so she used the December bounce back, kind of December, January bounce back coupon idea for that particular specialty facial, and she had lots of booking. I think, as a solo and she's fairly booked up, I think she had, in the one email she sent out, she got 9 bookings for January with that. So it works really, really well, and it just means that you have to get on it like right now, okay? I'm curious if you have any other ideas that you're putting into place for January or for December to ensure that January is busy for you, or maybe January isn't actually that slow for you at all. I'm really curious to hear, like, kind of where you are in your business, if that's the case. Like, how many years have you been doing this? What was it that finally got that kind of not so high of the seasonality? Not so high, the dips and the highs and the lows aren't so great. So, if you are one of our success aestheticians, spa owners, solos, then we want to hear from you because that absolutely helps everyone else with their own motivation and their own hopefulness. And Lord knows, this feels like a bit of a crazy year. Well, not a bit, it's a totally crazy year. And we need all the support that we can get. All right. So that's it for me for Thursday Spa Business Break. I will be back here in 2 weeks' time. If you need more support for your spa business, there's lots and lots of Facebook Lives here in under videos on my Facebook page. I have lots, I've got like 7 years worth of blogs on my website on kirstenfoss.com. And of course, if you know that you're ready to make some changes in your spa business, you're tired of kind of spinning your wheels and you really kind of don't know which way to go to make this thing grow better, then you can absolutely send me a DM. We can chat. It's no pressure to work together, but a lot of times we just need to chat to make sure, A, you have a path. B, to hear about what I would do with your business, and C, to see if we're a good fit, right? So all those things need to be taken into consideration. All right, that's it for me. Have a really great Thursday. Have a wonderful weekend, and we'll see you back here in a few weeks. Take care.